Good morning, all of you. We'll start the programming of timers and counters of 8051 microcontroller. Okay. And this topic is very important for the projects as well as for the examinations and all. Okay. So in the last class, we studied timers and counters of 8051 microcontroller. So it has two special function registers, timer counter control and timer mode control special function registers. Okay. So TCON is bit addressable, T mode is byte addressable one. So if you look at this TCON, the lower order 4 bits are used for interrupt function. The controller receives the interrupt through INT1 complement pin, then this flag will be set. Similarly, for INT0, this flag will be set. And what kind of interrupt? So this IT1 will decide what kind of interrupt, whether it is edge triggering or level triggering for INT1 pin. In IT0, it decide what type of interrupt it is, whether it is edge triggered or level trigger at 0. Okay, anyway, we are not going to use this lower order 4 bits of TCON register for timer counter operation. Okay, we are concentrating only the higher order 4 bits of TCON. Overflow flag for timer 1, overflow flag for timer 0. So whenever the timer 1 is reached its maximum value, the overflow will occur. The timer generate the interrupt to the processor. That time this TF1 equal to 1. Similarly, whenever timer 0 reaches the maximum count, this flag bit will be set. Right? Next one, to start your timer 1, this timer run control bit should be set. To stop the timer, timer run control bit should be reset. Similarly, timer 0, to start the timer 0, TR, timer run control 0 bit, timer run control for timer 0 bit should be set. Okay, so how to write the program, how to access this individual bit in the program? Either we can use TF1, TR1, TF0, TR0 in the name. Okay, or we may use TCON.7, that means this bit, TCON.6, TCON.5, TCON.4. So both method is allowed. Either individual bit names the programmer can specify in the assembly language program, as well as TCON.7654. In this way also we can specify. And next, just recollect the modes of operation of the timer counters. Mode 0, 13 bit timer. Okay, TH 8 bit, TL lower order 5 bit. So 5 plus 8, 13 bit timer. So 13 bit meaning 2 power 13, as many pulse the timer can able to count. Once it reaches the maximum count, then this timer 1 overflow flag or timer 0 overflow flag, whether we are using timer 0 or timer 1. This is general. Mode 1, 16 bit timer, 8 bit in loaded into TL, 8 bit loaded into TH. Total 16 bit, so 2 power 16. So that many number of clock pulse can apply to the timer counter. Once it reaches the maximum value, it will generate the interrupt, and the corresponding interrupt flag bit will be set, either TF1 or TF0. Mode 2, 8 bit timer, the speciality is auto reloaded. So the count value should be loaded into TH. So it will be automatically reloaded into TL whenever the interrupt occurs, whenever the overflow occurs. Okay, so these modes of operation we studied already. Okay, so I have written in the short way, right? So another important thing, whatever the crystal oscillator frequency, divided by 12. Okay, say for example, the microcontroller crystal oscillator frequency is 12 megahertz, then it is divided by 12. The clock pulse input to the timer counter circuit is 1 megahertz only, and the time period of this particular clock pulse is 1 microsecond, 1 by frequency time period. Say for example, oscillator frequency 22 megahertz, so 22 megahertz divided by 12, so you'll get 1.833 megahertz. This is the input signal to the timer counter circuit. Or the time period of this particular clock pulse is 0.546 microsecond. So depending on the problem statement, whether oscillator frequency 12 or 22 or 11.0592, so in 8051 microcontroller the oscillator frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. So it is divided by 12 and then applied to the timer counter circuit, the internal circuitry available. So divided by 12, you will get around 921.6 kilohertz, or the time period of the signal 1.085 microsecond. Please remember, the time period of the input pulse of timer counter. For your pulse, 1 microsecond time delay. The counter counts, if the timer counter count 256 clock pulse, then 256 microsecond time delay programmer can able to generate with the help of this. And it's also depends on which mode. See, look at mode 0, mode 1, mode 2. Out of these three mode, mode 1 can generate highest time delay because 16 bit timer, so 2 power 16 6 double 5 36. Depending on the clock frequency, we will calculate how much maximum time delay that particular mode can generate. Okay, so time delay depends on oscillator frequency, internal oscillator frequency, as well as what is the modes of operating of the timer. Next basic concept before start of the programming in timer counter: how to calculate the count value to be loaded in the timer. Okay, so already we discussed, but anyhow, in hexadecimal, suppose if you are representing in hexadecimal, I'm explaining for 16 bit counter, same concept will be applicable for others. For 16 bit timer, for 16 bit timer, maximum count is f of s, okay, minus, suppose I need to count only 5 pulses, okay, then that value which is loaded into the timer, lower order 8 bit in TL, higher order 8 bit in TH, plus 1. So this is the count to be loaded in the timer, maximum count. And how many count you want to, how many clock pulse you want to count, that value plus 1. Okay, in decimal 16 bit timer meaning you will get 6 double 5 36 minus how many count you want directly, that one. So whatever result, that result should be loaded in your timers. Okay, in hexadecimal, maximum possible value minus your count, how many clock pulse you want to count, plus 1. In decimal, 6 double 5 36 for 16 bit timer. 8 bit meaning calculate 2 power 8. 13 bit meaning calculate 2 power 13, that much value. So what is the maximum possible, or how to calculate the time period of the 16 bit timer? So this many number of clock pulses multiplied with the time period. example, suppose oscillator frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. Then we calculated the time period 1.085 microsecond. Okay, so this value, the maximum value, the count to be loaded plus 1 into 1.085 microsecond. So this is your total time delay. Similarly here also, if you multiply this, how many clock pulse the timer count multiplied by the time period of the input clock pulse, then you will get total time delay. This is for 16-bit timer, please remember. If it is 13-bit timer, then the maximum value is 1 FFT. If it is 13-bit timer, that is mode 0. Power 13 maximum count. Okay, how much it will come? Eight one nine two in decimal, in hexadecimal 1 FFH. So 8192 clock pulse it will count. 8192 clock pulse in decimal. If it convert into hexadecimal, you get 1 FFF. This is the maximum value. 8 bit meaning 2 power 8, 256 in decimal. FF in hexadecimal. So these are some basics we should know before starting the programming in timer counter. Okay, please remember to start the timer TR, timer uncontrolled bit. Okay, mode 0, mode 1, mode 2, timer 0 and timer 1, timer 0, timer 1, timer 0, timer 1. There are three, mode 3 usually we are not using, mode 0, 1, 2 only we will be using. And remember 13-bit timer, 16-bit timer, 8-bit auto reload. In 13-bit timer, TH 8-bit, TL lower order 5 bits. Next, T mode. How to select mode 0? If this M1, M0 is 00, then it is mode 0. Mode 0 of timer 1. 01. Mode 1 of timer 1. 10. Timer 1, mode 2. 11. Timer 1, mode 3. Similarly, this section for timer 0. If this is 00, mode 0, timer 0. 01, mode 1 of timer 1. 10, mode 2 of timer 0, and so on. We are not going to use the gate control bit here. Not using any external hardware control. Okay. So we'll start some small program so that you can understand clearly. One simple program. Create a square waveform of 50% duty cycle. They are not mentioning any time period. 50% duty cycle. That meaning your on time, off time will be equal. Okay. On 4 to 1/5 bit. 4 to 1/5 bit. Timer 0 used to generate the time delay. So port 1, 5th bit. That bit we have to generate some square waveform. 50% due to cycle. They are not mentioning what is the frequency of the square waveform and time period anything. 50% is equal on time off time. So you may load anything, any value.
Okay.
So timer 0. How to select timer 0? Mode first. T mode. This T mode is important for setting your mode. Timer 0, mode 1. Okay, I'll specify here also. Timer 0, mode 1. So this is the given in the problem itself. Use timer 0, mode 1, and generate the square waveform 50% duty cycle and P15. So mode 1, timer 0. Timer 0, this section, okay? This section is timer 0. Timer counter 0. So this all should be 0, 0, 0. Don't worry about this. Okay. Next. Timer 0, mode 1. Mode 1 meaning this M1, M0 should be 0, 1. Correct? 0, 0 meaning mode 0. 0, 1 meaning mode 1. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. If you convert into hexadecimal, 0, 1, H. Okay, 0, 1, H. So we have to load 0, 1, H to the mode control register, which represents timer 0, mode 1. Okay, so before start of the program, you read the questions first, which timer we have to use and what is the mode of operation of the timer. Here it is timer 0. So you make it as all the bits of timer 1 as 0, 0, 0. Okay, if it is timer mode, meaning counter slash timer bar, it should be 0, which indicates timer mode. Gate external hardware control we are not using. So M1, M0, 0, 1 for mode 1. So first line of the program. Move. T mode, comma, hash 0, 1, H. Okay, so timer 0, mode 1 configure. So equal time delay 50%. They are not mentioning any timing value, so you load any value in TL0. Move TL0. Say for example, I'm giving F2. And move TH0 some other value FF. Okay, these two I'm giving randomly. Next, take the complement of P15 upon reset. P1, P2, P3 pins are always high state only. So I'm writing complement of P1.5. Now call your delay program. E call your subroutine. I have named my subroutine as delay. E call delay. And repeat the same procedure. Where is here meaning at this time? Repeat the same procedure. So now write the program for delay. Delay is a subroutine. Delay is a subroutine. So delay to start the timer. Particularly, we are using timer 0. So set timer run control bit 0. When you execute this particular line, your timer 0 will start. Okay, so one instruction, jump on bit, go to the specific location, and another one is jump on the bit is 0, go to the specific location. So in the jump instruction, I think I have missed this particular one. I explained everything. Jump on bit. Similarly, one more instruction available, JNB. JNB mean JB meaning if the particular bit is set, go to this location. JNB meaning if the particular bit is 0, then go to that particular location. Okay, please note down JNB, one instruction available. So we know that whenever the timer reaches the maximum count, the flag bit will be set. Okay, the flag bit will be set. Now it is timer 0, so check for flag bit of timer 0, TF0. Okay, if TF0, if TF0 equal to 0, that is the meaning of this statement. Jump on no bit. That is, if TF0 flag bit is 0, again meaning in the same location. So whenever the timer reaches the maximum value, then only this TF0 will become 1. That is, overflow will be occurs. Then the timer generate the interrupt to the processor. So wait, the timer wait till the timer 0 overflow. So the keyword is, the instruction is JNB, jump on no bit, meaning as long as the timer flag 0 is 0, wait in this stage 1. Okay, once this TF0 becomes 1, then execute the next line. So stop your count timer, clear timer run control bit, stop your timer 0. Then clear your, once it is overloaded, that overflow occurs, this TF0 become 1. Now clear that TF0 also, and then return. Okay. So I'll repeat the program once again. There is no specific time delay because this is the first program for you. So how to configure mode 1 timer 0, look, based on the status of T mode, we have to convert those binary information into hexadecimal. So 01, T mode 01 meaning timer 0 mode 1. Load some random value in TL0, TH0. Mode 1 meaning how many bit operation it is. Mode 1, 16 bit timer mode. Okay, 16 bit timer mode meaning when the timer reaches FFFF, when the timer reaches FFFF, then the TF0 become 1. Once the TF0 become 1, stop your timer. Timer uncontrolled bit 0 meaning stop your timer. And then make it as flag bit as 0 again. Then return. Return meaning where the program flow will go. A call delay, next line. Return meaning your program execution flow go to next instruction after your call instruction. A call delay, this delay instruction will be executed. Then if you write return, it will go to the next line. What is the instruction available in the next line? Yes, jump here. Short jump here. Label is here. Where is that label? Now the TL0, TH0, load the same value again in complement of P15. So you will get 0101 01. Equal on time, equal off time. At P1.5. At port 150 bit. So do you understand this program? Or any doubt? At this particular point, please, someone has to be response. Okay, don't be idle. I have not calculated any time delay here. just I am explaining how to use timer 0 mode 1. Is it understanding to you or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please remember this instruction. Jump on no bit, meaning as long as the particular bit is zero, repeat the same operation. Okay. This particular instruction said, wait until the timer zero overflow flag is set. When the timer zero overflow flag is set, if the count is reached maximum. So this is which mode? Mode 1. So mode 1 meaning, so what are the instruction we loaded? FFF2. So FFF2. FFF2 meaning we have loaded FFF2. FFF2. So this is loaded into TL, this is loaded into TFL. So it should be counted now. FFF3. Okay. FFF4. And so on. So until it reaches the maximum count, the TF0 equal to 0. The TF0 equal to 0. The TF0 equal to 0. Once it reaches the maximum count, on applying the next clock pulse, on applying the next clock pulse till this particular point, TF equal to 0. On applying the next clock pulse, your flag bit equal to 1. After reaching the maximum value, then for the next clock pulse, your flag bit will be 1. That time, the next line of the program will start executing. Overflow occurs, so interrupt generated, that is TF equal to 1. So now stop your timer and clear your overflow flag and go back to return. Again, repeat the same procedure. Now take the complement. Let's jump to... S jump here meaning again program will go to from the starting, load the same value. Now take the complement of P15. Okay. Suppose if you want to know what is the time of this on time, what is this on time, what is this off time from this particular example, you can calculate. FFF2 to FFF. Check how many clock pulse. FFF2 to up to FFF. So can we calculate that? Maximum value is FFFF. The count loaded in the timer is FFFF2. FFFF. Okay, if it in terms of hexadecimal, then we have to add plus 1. Let oscillator frequency, internal oscillator frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. So for one clock pulse, the fundamental time period is 1.085 microsecond. Okay, so one times if the daily program runs, then this much of delay we are generating. FFFFF minus the count loaded in the timer plus 1. I think you will get 14.
Yes, sir.
Correct? 14. 14.1.085 microsecond. So 15.19 microsecond. This is for either off time or on time. Okay, this is for either one half time or on time. So for a complete clock pulse, if you want to calculate, we are generating the square waveform. This 15.19 is either on time or off time. We are using 50% of the duty cycle. So on time also same amount, and off time also 15.1 microsecond. So if you want to calculate total time period, then 2 times of 15.11 microsecond. So if you want to calculate the frequency generated at this particular pin P15, then F equal to 1 by T. Then F equal to 1 by T. This way we can calculate the total time period which is generated at port 1 fifth pin with the help of this program. So 30.38 microsecond total time period. This entire time period is 30.38 microsecond. So F equal to 1 divided by 30.38 microsecond. Then you will calculate the frequency of the square waveform generated at port 1 fifth pin. If you do in terms of decimal value, then maximum count, that is 65536 minus the decimal value, that's it. So we have loaded in terms of hexadecimal, then maximum value minus hexadecimal plus 1. So I hope you understand how to use timer 0 mode 1. It's a generalized program. So I have taken some example to explain to you how to write the program. Second example. Example 2, find the delay generated by the timer 0. The programs are given. Find the delay. Generated by timer 0. In the following program. Okay, so the programs is given in the question. Just you have to find out how much time delay. Actually, we have done in the previous example. It is not required because completed now. So in this program itself, I explained everything. Okay. So how to calculate how much delay generated and how to calculate the total time period of the output clock pulse at P15. So it's not required. Move on to some other example. Let's restart. Second example, the crystal oscillator frequency is 22 megahertz. The crystal oscillator frequency of a microcontroller is given in 22 megahertz. Using timer 1 mode 1. Use timer 1 mode 1. And port 1 third pin. So in this example, the first one, timer 0 mode 1. Second example, timer 1 mode 1. Oscillator frequency 22 megahertz, that is given in the problem itself. And port 1, third pin. Okay. With respect to this, so some programs are given here. Clear P1.3. Just for analysis only. Clear P1.3. So timer 1 mode 1. What value we have to load? Timer 1 mode 1. Can anyone tell now? Timer 1, mode 1. So this is timer 1. So this all the bits are 0000. Okay. So this one is 0. For timer mode, this particular bit also 0. Mode 1 meaning 01. 00 mode 0, 01 mode 1. So 0001, 000. So your value is in hexadecimal 10H, correct? If you load 10H in T mode, timer mode control register, which represent mode 1, timer 1. So do you understand this? What value to be loaded in T mode?
Yes, sir.
So initially they have cleared the P1.3, that meaning P1.3 pin is 0 now. Next, move timer mode register with 10H, okay, which represents timer 1 mode 1. Next, so they have loaded some value, move TH0 comma 0FFH and move TL0 comma 00H. Now set P13 again. Initially P13 is 0, now P13 is 1. Now set it TCON6. What is TCON6? So instead of using set bit TR1, we may use TCON.6, that is start the timer. Okay, start the timer. In the previous example, we used TR0 or TR1 directly. So instead of using TR or TF, we can use TCON.6. TCON.6 meaning this particular pin, TR1. If it is 1, meaning timer 1 started. Okay. So wait until the timer 1 overflow flag is set. Timer 1 overflow flag available in TCON.7, 7th position, last bit. So TCON.7. What is the meaning of this statement? Wait until TF1 equal to 1. Again. Once overflow occurs, that is FFFFF in mode 1. Then stop the timer. TCON.6. Then clear your flag bit. TCON.7. Now clear 4210. Just simple program given. Just we are going to analyze this program only. So this is the program. Now, shall we calculate total time delay which is generated in this particular timer? Timer 1, mode 1, 22 megahertz clock frequency. Okay. Analyze this program. Analyze the assembly language program and calculate the time delay. Calculate the time delay generated by the timer. So this that is the question here. 22 megahertz provided, timer 1, mode 1, everything is given. Now calculate. Because mode 1 meaning what is the maximum counter? Mode 1 meaning what is the maximum count? 16-bit timer. Yeah, up to FFFF. Okay, with that only we may calculate how much time delay this particular timer given. So what is the oscillator frequency? 22 megahertz. Oscillator frequency 22 megahertz. So if you multiply 22 megahertz divided by 12, this is the input to your timer. 22 by 12. Calculated already, no? Starting of the today class. If the oscillator frequency is 22, okay. 1.833 megahertz or timer count one clock pulse that represent 0.546 microsecond. 0.546 microsecond. Okay. This is divided by 12. That input applied to your timer. Okay. So what is the time period of this? T equal to 0.546 microsecond. Now calculate total count. How to calculate the total count now? Total delay. Total delay equal to maximum possible count. This is mode 1, so FFF minus what is the value they have loaded in the program? FF. THFF TL00. So FF00. Maximum count minus the count loaded in the TLTH plus 1 multiplied with 0.546 microsecond. Okay. So from this you will get around 256 plus 0.546 microsecond. You'll get 139.2 microsecond. With the help of this particular program, the programmer can able to generate up to 139.2 microsecond time delay. So maximum time delay, how much we can generate? For 22 megahertz oscillator frequency, timer 1 mode 1, if you use timer 1 mode 1, maximum how much time delay we can generate? Any idea? To get maximum time delay, what value we have to load here? I need more time delay. So what value I have, I supposed to load here in TH0, TL0? 0000. So for 22 megahertz oscillator frequency, the maximum possible time delay. The maximum possible time delay, that is FFFFF minus 0000 plus 1. Okay, that is 65536. 16 bit counter meaning it can count up to 65536 clock pulses. So 22 megahertz. 22 megahertz divided by 12. So input to the timer frequency or input to the timer clock pulse time period, that is 0.546 microsecond. Okay, so 35.782 microsecond. 35.782 microsecond. This is the maximum delay we can generate. Or in terms of millisecond, sorry, 35782 millisecond.